गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो दिस इज अवर प्रैक्टिकल, इंडस्ट्रियल इंजीनियरिंग प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 1। सो इन दिस सब्जेक्ट कंटेन अ 6 चैप्टर। सो इन दिस प्रैक्टिकल सो ओनली 6 असाइनमेंट एक्चुअली वी नीड टू कवर। सो आउट ऑफ 6 दिस इज द फर्स्ट असाइनमेंट based on our chapter number 1. So here I will give certain questions to you. You have to get it solved and submit on mail or WhatsApp, so that I will collect all this and it will preserve me for your term work purpose. So here's assignment number 1. In this define production, productivity and its importance from industrial engineering point of view. So this is the question number 1. So in this assignment, question number 1 is that based on chapter number 1, define production, productivity, its importance from industrial engineering point of view. So already this part is over, and after getting these all questions, just I will give the hint, and here we'll cover numerical problems based on productivity. So you can note down these questions in this assignment number 1. Define production, productivity, its importance from industrial engineering point of view. Then second question, explain in brief contribution of F.W. Taylor and F. Gilbert in the development of industrial engineering. So question number 2. So in this chapter, what is actually contributions of F.W. Taylor and Gilbert in the development of industrial engineering? So this is the questions in brief contribution of F.W. Taylor and F. Gilbert. You can write this. Now question number 3 is there. Explain the brief various factors affecting on productivity. Also state at least 3 ways to improve the productivity. The question number 3 is there. Explain
higher factor.
So this question number 3 is there. Explain in brief various factors affecting on productivity, also state at least three ways to improve the productivity. Then next question number 4 is there.
Hint related to this question. And exam related to first question related to production and productivity. Productivity, which is actually output divided by input. But a brief explanation should be that. So, in which way we can increase the productivity and production?
So, related to question number 1, define productions. Production is nothing but quantity to be produced in the particular period or volume. The volumes actually produced in the specified period means 8 hours, how much quantity actually produced. And productions means output divided by input. Output means the product. After selling that product, whatever revenue you will get generated, so that is output. And input may be labor and their salary, machines and their cost of manufacturing, overhead cost, material cost, light bills. So these are the inputs. So this ratio is the productivity. And its importance from the industrial engineering point of view is that the production and productivity, if we increase this both quantity, definitely there is effect on the cost. Cost will be less. And when the cost will be less, we can expect more profit in this. Now, in order to increase the production and productivity, which point actually we need to consider? So here's the different point we have discussed. Factors affecting on the productivity. So many factors are there. So manpower, this is a first factor, and related to this, different scheme is actually required. Then after that, working hours, technologies, so advanced manufacturing facility, plant layout, location of the plant. So these things actually we require, working conditions, and after this, how to increase this productivity. The very simple thing is that productivity we can improve by reducing the cost related to the materials, cost related to manpower, cost related to overheads. If you reduce this, and if you sell that product with more profit, definitely productivity will get increased. Means industrial engineering location, this is also very important. Type of layout, this is very important. Manpower, production planning, and raw materials, and working conditions. These things actually affect on this production and productivity. Then next, explain in brief about the contribution of FW Taylor. So already I told this, FW Taylor, this is related to method study. Which methods you are going to manufacture your product. So this is actually very required. And F Gilbert, this is related to motion study. Motion study, here we can use the camera to study about this. These two things actually helps in the development of industry. Method study, present methods, you have to select the points related to this, critical examinations, and after that installations and recording part is there. And in the motion study, we can use the thirdlings. So some motion we can reduce, or some motions time we can reduce. So FW related to method study, F Gilbert related to motion study. Brief explanation you have to give. Explain the various factors affecting on product state also. Three ways to improve the production and productivity. So here, so many factors are there. So out of this, type of the production, critical facility plans, then use of the advanced manufacturing process, technologies that manpower, working conditions, quality, rejections should not be there. So many factors are there. So you can explain in briefs and state the various factors for improvement. Technologically, if you change, definitely productivity will get increased. Minimums the wastage of the time on the shop floors definitely increase. Use of the different types of source of energy instead of the light, solar system, etc. It can increase. Define the work studies, the study of present methods and its objective and work study questions. Select a job, recording, then critical exam. Same, whatever things we have studied in method, the same things are there. So you can explain in brief about this. So these are the four questions related to assignment number one. Have you noted these all four questions? It is okay. Then I will go to the question number five, numerical problem related to this assignment. Numerical problems will be there. Okay, shall I go to a numerical problem? After this, we will solve numerical problems. Have you written all these four questions? Hello? This is the assignment number one. Six assignment will be there. Hello? Have you written all four questions? Shall I go for next fifth question, numerical questions related to productivity? Anybody give a response to me so that I will come to know that your writing part is over. This is practicals related to our industrial engineering. Hello? Yes, sir. Okay, thank you. So we'll go to the next numerical problem related to this. So with these problems, we need to calculate the machine productivity. So study has been made in one of the industry. In that industry, three machines are there. Working hours per machine it is given. Number of machines it is given, and production unit in that shift or the total production units. Actually, three machines. But here, so we have to calculate the productivity of machine.
So here,
one number, suppose lathe machines are there, how many lathe machines are there? 400. Milling machines are there, 450, like this way. And production unit produced by this, that is the, yeah, 1,08,000 and 1,25,000. This is the quantity. So this is the data we have got from the industry. Now we have to calculate the productivity of the machine. So first of all, the productivity, it means the output divided by n. So here we have to calculate first the total machine hour. So first we have to calculate total machine hours. How to calculate total machine? Working hours per machine into number of machines. So total machine hours we have to calculate. So total machine hours for machine number one. So here's 200 into 400. Whatever the total machine hours, yes, total machine hours is equal to, for number one machine, working hours 200 into number of machines 400. Total machine hours related to machines 225 into 450. How much? That is related to the third machine 220 into 500. Total machine power. So how much for related to machines 2? Related to machines 2. Related to machine 2, as per my calculation, 101,250. 101,250. This is for machine one. Two. So what is the total machine hours for machine number three? Machine number three. Machine number three. For my calculation. So with this given data, what actually we have calculated here is total machine hours. Means working hours per machine. There are two types, working hours and idle hours. So one machine, the production of the one machine, it is going on totally 2 hours, 200 hours we can make use of this, and such type of machines with us, that is 400. So totally machine hours we have utilized here for first machines of 80,000, second machines 1,01,250, third machine 1,15,000. So this is the machine utilization. Now how much quantity we have produced for each machine, accordingly we can decide the productivity per machine. Then productivity per machine. Per machine. Output divided by productivity per machine, this is equal to output divided by input. What is the output here? Production unit. So related to first machine, production unit produced, that is 95,000, and related input is 80,000. So 95,000. So related to first machine. What is output here? This divided this one. What is the answer here? Calculate. What is the answer for this? So my answer is 1.18. This is the productivity of first machine. What is the productivity of second machine? This is the production period. 1,10,000 divided by. So calculate this. How much is the productivity of second machine? So my answer is 1.08. So what is the unit here? 125 divided by 1.18. How much? Again, we have 1.08. This is the answer. So, machine number one, that is the more productivity. Now, why the productivity of machine number 2 and 3 is less, or machine 2 and 3 are equal? So while taking the work study, you can concentrate on these two machines. The problems related to machines 2 and 3, because the less productivity is there, need to increase the productivity, production, or any other thing related to this machine. So what is the problems? Maybe working condition problem, technology problems, production planning problems, material problems, then inherent problems, contingency problems. So what is the actual problems or present methods you have to study, make the improvement in the present method and try to increase this. So this is actually things we require in the industry, and inside the productivity of machines, we can decide the productivity of man, we can decide the productivity related to overheads, we can decide the productivity of the material also. So output divided by input, this is standard formula. But through this, one thing you will come to know that which machines the productivity, or which material the productivity, or which labor productivity is less or more. If it is less, then how we can increase this? Which factors actually we require to increase this? So factor affecting on the productivity and ways to improve the productivity. Same factor here you have to consider while taking the decisions at a management level. So this is the simple examples related to the assignments number one. Anybody having any problems?
Sir,
इतिहास एनीबडी हैविंग एनी प्रॉब्लम्स हियर हेलो एनी क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू दिस न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम Now you can write this total problems and as it is you can get it submit. So before next practical you have to complete it and submit to me in my email or WhatsApp so that I will collect all. This is our journal and here as per the university rules we need to give the marks out of 25. Already we have solved this problem. You can write as it is. Okay. And remaining four questions also you can write. Answer of four questions, totally five questions. It is here. Okay. Now, is it okay? Hello? Is it okay now? Okay, so up to here, sir, you can write the assignment. And one more problems now I will take. So this is actually the part of our syllabus, but you have to know this. It is not actually part of our assignment, but you know the how we can calculate the productivity of the different work piece or different product. Okay. So shall I remove this? Have you written all this thing? Hello? Okay, thank you. So now we'll go to the this next problem, but you don't write this problem. So you can consider the one more examples related to this. this is the problem, not to write in your assignment, just for trial purpose I have taken this. Compute the various productivity indices for the following information. Output is given and all other things are input. Labor is there, material is there, capital is there. Capital cost means the initial cost of purchasing all equipment, machinery, etc. Energy means light bill we have to pay. Other expenses means in office people writing certain orders, presenting, releasing of salary. The other expenses related to the documentations actually we required in the production. So this is the other expenses. 2000 it is there. So here you can calculate the productivity of labor. So what is the productivity of labor? First, productivity of labor. Labor productivity. This is the output 1 lakh. Only labor is the output 10,000. So in this case, labor productivity is same. Related labor's numbers you have to take. Output that is fixed to all. So labor productivity is state. So what is the material productivity? So material productivity, what is the material input? 20,000. So material productivity. Output remains same. Divided by material. So material productivity is 5. Similarly, you can go for capital productivity. So third, capital productivity. Capital productivity. 1 lakh. Energy productivity. They fix the other expenses. So other expenses, that is the 50. This is the individual productivity. Labor productivity means output divided by labor input. Material productivity means output divided by material input. Capital productivity means the output divided by capital input, energy, same thing, and other expenses. So this is the individual productivity. But how we can calculate the total productivity? Total productivity, how we can calculate total productivity? So this is the individual productivity, total productivity. So output is 1 lakh, but what is the total input that you have to write? Okay, so in this input contain labor, materials, capital, energy, and other expenses. So here is labor 10,000. Material. Capital. Energy. After that, other expenses. Other expenses. So you can calculate 1 lakh divided by the input of all this. Labors, materials, capitals, then energy and other expenses. Other expenses. How much? You can calculate this. So my answer is 1.61. So this total productivity. Total productivity is actually 1.61. This is my answer. So industry, you can calculate the individual productivity. Main purpose to calculate the individual productivity, whether labor problem is there, material problem is there, capital's productivity problem is there, energy production is there, or other expenses. So here's a less productivity, there is a problems in our the working productivity, there is a less productivity. Capital productivity, there is a problem. So through these examples, you have to study why this problem in the capital productivity. Capitals means yours the initials, measuring instruments, equipments, jigs, fixtures, the others devices actually we required in machines, machine cost. This actually here problem is there's either input should be less, means capital productivity if you want to increase, then this input must be less, means this should be less. Now once we purchase that equipment, we cannot sell that because it is useful. Then how we can reduce this capital productivity. So So here we can increase the capital productivity, very simple thing, with less input. Means our capital productivity, if you want to increase, you have to decrease your input in the capital. Now, initially, if you have purchased all these things, we cannot sell. But next time, if you want to go for expansions, you can purchase such machine having all the devices, maybe jigs, the study rest or measuring instrument. It should be inherent to that machine. You can select such machine. No need to change the belt, gear driven. Nowadays, you might have seen in our workshop or in the industry, two types of plates are there, belt driven and the gear driven. So belt driven machine is more effective than gear driven, or gear driven is more effective than belt driven. If we consider the initial capital cost, then gear driven machines, it is high cost, 1.5 more than our belt driven. So if you having such type of the workshop, then instead of purchasing the this gear driven machines, you can also go for belt driven, because your capital cost will get decreased. And you can demand in such way that there should be automatic the jigs and purchase, jig and fixture should be there. Automatic device, no need to go for manufacturing of the this gauges to measure that instrument dimension. So as possible as you have to reduce the equipment purchasing in the expansion. Now presently we cannot change the capital productivity, because already we have purchased all the equipment which is the permanent in our industry. This we cannot reduce. But in the expansions in the future, if you want to increase the capital productivity, then you can think and you can take the decision in such way that your capital cost will get decreased. Next, productivity is the material productivity. Materials means around 60% materials, the cost related to our total selling price. Means total selling price is 100, then around 60% the rupees or materials you have to spend for manufacturing of such components. So here, material productivity, if you want to increase, then purchase such much material, or you can change the dealers. You can go for more information, same materials within the less cost. How we'll get? This is one thing. Second thing is that the parallel materials can be used with a less cost, then productivity also get increased. And next point, that is the labor. Labor productivity, how we can increase? Labor productivity we can increase in such way that one man can handle more than two, three machines, so that less manpower is required with the same output. So in such way, we can reduce the labor. Other expenses also we can reduce by using a computer technology. The one computer, one man can handle all these things nowadays in one office. So these other expenses also we can reduce. Then energy, by using that solar system, we can reduce the productivity. Instead of purchasing the wheels from the MSCB, if you use the solar system, energy productivity we can reduce. So like this way, you can reduce the labors, materials, capitals, energy and other expenses, and definitely last total productivity may get increased because here input is less and output is more. This is one thing. Otherwise, you can increase the output with the same input. So instead of 1 lakh, instead of 1 lakh, you can make here 1.5 lakhs. So here 1.5 lakh. So how to increase that, you have to study. Either you can increase the output by more production, or you can reduce the input. In such way, the productivity will get increased. So this is about the our practical numbers one and assignment number one. Each practical will take one assignment based upon the given chapter. Now this is related to chapter number one. Next time we'll take assignment on chapter number two. So you have to submit all this assignment before next practical. And tomorrow we'll going to conduct one quiz test related to our chapter number three, that is the ergonomics and industrial safety. So tomorrow we'll conduct the MCQ types of test. 10 questions will be there related to ergonomics and industrial safety. Okay, with this we conclude that our time is over. Okay, so thanks to all of you once again. We'll stop here. Thank you.